It out, make it do and do without.
I thought I was under the bathroom. Who's the baby? Oh, that's Homer and Lydia's first baby. Yeah, she's pretty bad. It's
Well, you're not all.
In the morning, if you wake up and the sun does not appear, I will be here. In the morning, if you wake up and the future is unclear, when you need to speak your mind, I will listen and I will be here to watch you grow in beauty, tell you all the things you want to me. We'll be together, 'cause I will be here. The seasons were made for change, so our lifetimes were made for years. And I will be here. In the morning, if you wake up and the future is unclear, seasons were made for change, so our lifetimes were made for years. I will be right here, we'll be together.
Walking life's journey hand in hand, taking the path that heaven has planned, over life's bleak and barren land, Jesus and you and me, Jesus and you and me, walking together we three. We'll walk together through this life forever, Jesus and you and me. Never a joy that we won't share, never a sorrow, never a care, better than one or even a pair. Jesus and you and me, Jesus and you and me, walking together we three, we'll walk together through this life forever, Jesus and you and me, longing the pearly gates to see, praying for heaven glorious and free, happy that forever will be, Jesus and you and me, Jesus and you and me, walking together we three, we'll walk together through this life forever, Jesus and you and me. You should always be prepared. Well, I am prepared. I know you folks couldn't make sounds like that. We were given, I don't know if it was a crystal bell or a glass bell at our wedding, and I just love that bell. But when we moved to Arkansas, it got broken. And so now I got these kind of bells that grandchildren can hide them under the couch and they still work. I may use it yet again today. Afternoon after lunch, we both went into the wardrobe and we started looking around. I'm just so thankful there were no mud daubers had built on.
Okay. This way, Gabby. All right.
I don't know. They might have a different explanation, but I was like, Mom, why did you not have a white wedding dress? And she said, well, we wanted something practical that I would wear again. And I just asked her, have you worn it again?
Today.
No, not till today.
I had a lady who 2 days before the wedding said, I would love to make you a really pretty white fluffy wedding dress. And he wanted green, so she says, well, I'll make you a pretty bright green fluffy wedding dress. Now that sounded good to me. He said, nope. And I said, well, whatever, I don't care. I just want to marry him. And today, I might not still like my dress that well, but he wants me to wear it, that's fine. I'm just happy to be with him.
And the other thing I didn't say, the song that we just sang was written by Warren Wilson for his daughter Becky, their wedding in October of 68. And Sylvia and I sang this song together to one another on our wedding day in 72. Wow.
And Becky is still a very dear friend.
And I thought that wasn't the first time you've sung it.
No.
I didn't ask you how many. I bet you don't know, do you?
Yeah, they've sung it many times over the years.
Okay.
So together, you're supposed to do that together. Daddy, what are you doing?
Oh, hand on hand.
It's been a long time.
Just cut out a little piece.
Don't make a big mess, eh? Make it the smaller pieces.
Here's something to put a piece on.
Wow. Okay, now everybody else can have some.
Yeah, that's fine. You can just set the knife down and we'll deal with helping other people. You want to try to feed each other? Just a little tiny piece. Good job. It's nice and sweet.
Among other non-essential things that I told them, I'm very impressed with your daughter. I later learned that her father said, uh-uh. And her mother said, uh-huh. But I didn't learn that until a long while later. I should say that Sylvia's grandmother and her mother helped me land Sylvia. Okay, Melanie said that this is an important picture. And for practical purposes, this would be Crystal, Colorado. I should back up just a tad. Sylvia, don't want to bore anybody. Later in the providence of God, Sylvia went away to high school in 68. And there at high school at Little Creek Academy, she was privileged to room with Melody Woolsey. And I got to go with Betty and Sylvia to deliver her there. Now, that was part of the story in 68. I turned 18 and Vietnam was trucking along. And I registered as a conscientious objector and I was accepted and I could serve my time at the States in a school, a hospital, or Forest Service. I didn't realize all the options, but I knew that I wanted to spend my time at Wildwood. In the providence of God, I got to live in the Harmer home with Dr. and Mrs. Harmer. Sylvia is an only child, and I got to live in their home for the time that Sylvia was away at Little Creek Academy. I had her bedroom, her bed, her stereo, her dress of drawers, and I got to live there. Sylvia did not know that she was under close observation, but she did know that her mother liked me and her father liked me, and we did a lot of hiking and a lot of other things together.
I think she knew.
Are you one?
I think she knew. I was hoping.
Could you fill in some more story?
No. I want to keep her as a friend.
You were being as sneaky as you thought you were.
I am going to learn some other things. I understood that that revelation came to Sylvia a little later on when one time she wanted to go somewhere where I was going and her father said no. And she said, well, why not? And he said, because David Mason will be there.
It was a group hike.
Yeah, it was a group hike. And I don't have any of this pre-planned, and so I'm just thinking what to say tactfully.
So I'll pick up right here a second.
Okay.
So when he said I couldn't go on this group hike, I said, why not? Well, David Mason's going. I said, so? I've been on lots of hikes that he was on. Well, he likes you. Okay. I may have known it before, but my folks didn't know I knew it. And my dad didn't know. My mom probably did. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. And just to keep it simple and move forward and on down, her father was diagnosed with cancer at age 51. And he had a multiple myeloma, started with a broken clavicle, and it progressed. And Sylvia has completed high school, and I no longer live in the home, and we've gone different ways and places, but keeping up with one another. And I was very untactful and did some things very much the wrong way on several occasions. But one thing that I did the right way, I prayed and prayed and prayed. And I think Sylvia was praying and praying and praying. and I know her mother was, and I know my mother was. And I sang a great deal of the success and the blessed life that we've had is due to having prayed and prayed and prayed and in and out of difficulty and back and forth and up and down. So Sylvia graduated the spring of 70. This picture here is actually taken in October of 71. And Sylvia has been at some Dark County mission projects in West Virginia. I've been in Michigan. I'm done with my Army time, and I'm building houses, and Sylvia's deciding on her future. But her
father... differences between him and my dad. And we figured out how to resolve them on scripture. And my mom was satisfied with our resolution. So he looked at her and he said, "So now can I have her?" And he said, "Yes." He came and grabbed me. He tried to kiss me, and it was a couple of days before he could kiss me.
And they got married, and he never got down and proposed.
And then I told him a couple of years later, "You know, you never asked me." But the next day, I thought I was engaged, but I didn't know for sure. We hiked up this crack here, and up into the cliffs, and got in some really dangerous places where we were doing handholds, and it's 1,000 feet down, and we can't reach the next one. And so he gets in there, and it's kind of a crack, and I climb up on his shoulders and kind of brace my hand in a little crack that was about 4 inches wide and lunged for the next handhold. And got it. Pulled myself up and then had to watch him come up. And we were praying there wouldn't be anything harder because there's no earthly way we could go down. You don't find handholds going down with them. But we made it to the top. And then we hiked up here, and it was all snow-capped. Had a wonderful hike. Went back the back side that was like a rock slide or sand slide. You just jump and slide. Found a log trail, walked back, and marked his camp at 6 o'clock in the evening, exactly when we told my mom we'd be back. That was the day. And by then, I thought I was engaged, because he was asking me wedding plans.
Any of you who have been in the West know that these mountains are very deceptive. You can look at it from down here, and oh.
We can't hear you.
Oh, Sylvia. Will you put up with me another year?
I want to live with you forever. 50 years is just the beginning of eternity.
They didn't live.
There is something about being married 50 years and happy.
He's so proud he could do that.
And that is something that Sylvia and I have that is special. I have to keep on telling.
He does that quite often, by the way, not just to show off. He does that all the time, but it's really funny.
She was 13 years old. So it was sometime in the past. And we cultivated a better relationship than what we'd had before. And I didn't realize that I could actually come back alive from the trip or that she would be alive. A little while later, she's working with me in Minnesota. And she says, "Dad, you know what? If you were eligible, I consider you for a husband." Oh, say, When your adult daughter will tell you that, that's pretty good. In the drawer in my bedroom, I've got a Father's Day card. And she says, Dad, when you get old, you can come live with me. I've got that card in the same place.
All I can say is as her first roommate, I've never known anybody with more determination and energy in my life. And she still got it 50 years later. Well, actually, 52 or 3 years later. Yeah, we just had two very special years together, and what a privilege to be friends. And then who would have ever dreamed I would end up in Arkansas, a mile away from my roommate? So God is really blessed, because my folks bought David's folks place, and then we came to visit them, and then we fell in love with the Ozarks and moved out here too. So we've been here since 91.
Well, I want to say I was really blessed. I prayed and prayed I'd have a good roommate, because I wasn't used to going off to school and being away from my family. And I got the roommate God had for me, and we've been friends ever since.
Well, I'll tell you what, if they would get up at 5 o'clock in the morning, I had to be at the sand to work at the hospital sand at 5 in the morning. And by the time lights were out and whatever, we're supposed to be going to bed and go to sleep. This girl, if I hit the pillow, I was gone. She was out there doing jumping jacks, 100 jumping jacks, 10 o'clock at night, to wind down. And she was the first one that was given permission to have a little tape recorder of Del Delker and whatever music to play to help her go to sleep. And I got to benefit from that. Anyway, we had some good memories. One other thing, though, when he's talking about them climbing up in that mountain, I had the privilege, or I made the mistake, one of the two, of going home with her in Wildwood one time. And she says, well, we're just going to go hike up this mountain behind Wildwood, Georgia. And so we hiked up there. Now, I'm pretty active, but I wasn't prepared for that day. And she says, oh, let's just jog down and run down. So we ran down back to Wildwood, and then she says, well, Lookout Mountain's just right over there across the highway. And so we go hike up there, and then she wanted to run down that mountain. And I don't ever run down a mountain, because once you start running, your eyeballs are going like this, and your socks are down around your ankles, and if you fall, you're just going to roll. And I have never run down a mountain since then. I don't think I've ever gone for a hike with you.
She learned her lesson.
I know, but I had a very blessed weekend, and one thing that impressed me the most was that at 5 o'clock in the morning, David was living in their home. I'm not sure where we stayed. Somewhere.
We had two bedrooms.
I can't even remember that. But every one of them got up in the morning, and they all went in their own little special place, and they had their devotion with the Lord in the morning. And that really impressed me. And so when we, for my birthday, our senior year, she gave me the book, The Great Controversy Between Christ and Satan. And I still have that book and the little note she wrote in there. It really, really touched my heart.
Amen. Thank you, Melody.
Well, I wanted to say something before we have to take off. We're from Van Buren area, so it's about 2.5 hours away. But we were thankful we could come today, and we got to know David and Sylvia, I think it was around 2003, at some events we went to, Songs for His People and different things. And I was young and unmarried, and my wife was young and unmarried at those meetings. And they were always gracious to invite us in and provide a time of fellowship. And were counseling us while we were engaged and 40. and they've been a blessing to Clea and her mother. You and my wife's mother were very close.
You loved her.
Yeah, yeah. And so, a lot of fond memories, a lot of thank yous for all you've done for us. And you blessed us.
Amen.
To get out to a country setting and found the Springs to be that, what we were looking for. But we were struggling, trying to get going, and a little bit hard to keep a job going out here and to try to cover all the bases with what we had at that time. But I'll never forget the first time I remember meeting Sylvia, and then Daniel was with her, was when I had to park at the top of a hill because I wasn't able to drive his vehicle down the rough terrain. And it was a 2-mile walk from where I had to park to where our cabin was. So I had gotten some groceries and was carrying them, you know, doing the 2-mile walk until I could get like a better 4x4 vehicle. As I was walking, this little, I think it was a Nissan or a little truck pulled up behind me and walking down the road, and they said, "Hey, you know, how can we help you?" I said, "Well, actually, if you don't mind, I just live down here, and I think you just offered to give me a ride." So they gave me a ride, but they also had a couple of cases. They had applesauce and peaches. It was the best ever. If any of you all have ever eaten at the Mason's house and appreciated their bounty that they have there with canned homemade jarred fruits and everything, but I'll just never forget the kindness and going out of their way, and that was just a tidbit of what they've done to be a blessing to us. And I don't think we've done nearly as much to reciprocate, but we've really appreciated how you shine for Christ, you know, and in a practical way to us, your relationship and the way that you run things around your house and watch you take people in and out of your home and being a blessing, and you being one of those families. Just, you guys mean a lot to us, and just appreciate you, your walk with the Lord, and being willing to share with us some of your lives. There's a lot more to say, but you guys are very special to us.
Amen. Amen.
Picture of what it would be like.
I love that song.
I want to go to heaven, pick a never fading flower from the mountain overlooking the temple. Better than. at Jesus' table, oh, to eat the fruit of that land, to go back to earth, oh Lord. Sometimes I think that I could stay
to love. could never, never outlove the Lord.
That's awesome. That song shaped a lot of our lives, hasn't it?
Look at the camera.
Looks
okay,
excellent.
Push it, John.
Okay. He's taking video right now. This cat doing everything.
Why don't you join? With the video. Video's still going. Videos. Cute. All right.
Smile. Look.
Okay, that's video. Uh-oh. This is Darlene. Okay.
Okay. This is video now. Can you wave at the camera? Can you wave at the camera?
Yeah.
What's special about today?
Oh, January 5.
And
50 years ago.
Mother made a good choice.
50 years ago, you got married, huh?
I made a good choice.
Nice.
I cherish the treasure of you.
Yeah, that's right.
But
lifelong companion, I give myself to you.
Lifelong companion, I give myself to you.
You guys are so
God
sweet.
God has enabled me to love you faithfully and cherish the treasure of you. To you, God has.
cherish the treasure of you. Cherish the treasure, the treasure of you. You believe in me, and I believe in you, and we believe we found something worth holding on to, but we can't stop there, 'cause that won't be enough to make it work, to make it last when the life we share gets tough. But we're not in this thing alone. With you and God and me, 1 + 1 = 3. Three chords and a strand, we're too strong to break. We're one love bigger than us every time we pray. So if we're in the red, or if we're in, we can't get it right on our own. It's gonna take help, it's gonna take faith, but with you and God and me, 1 + 1 = 3. It's gonna take help, it's gonna take faith, but with you and God and me, 1 + 1 = 3. Spirits flee. and spoke your power.